Picture a man going on a journey behind sight and sound. He has left YouTube. He has entered the Patriot Zone.
Beep, beep.
You see, Robert got it. Well done, Robert. 2001, A Space Odyssey, which I was watching just before the stream started. Just because I've got an Aries coming. What's happened to my microphone? Let me adjust it while I'm chatting with you. Because I've got an Aries coming, like what Lou and Phil has been building. So I can't wait to do that. It's going to be fun. It's going to be a fun one. How the devil is everyone? Look, I've got my Kraken in a Terminator hand glass today. And these are all from part work upgrades. And I've got my Stormtroopers, the See No Evil, Hear No Evil. Ow, speak no evil. Let me put that down gently there, otherwise I'm going to drop it. Stay. That's good. That was a guess. It was a guess. Oh my God, well done for that. I was trying to do something a little bit more cryptic, and hopefully that's come through. Hello, Christian from Grantham.
Let's give it up big time. Hello, Christian from Grantham. Now let's get cracking.
I'm just tidying up here as I go along because, you know, I'm going to need to keep this free tonight. Now, you know me, I don't normally look at the instructions for these things. So in 5 minutes before the stream started, I thought I'd have a look. It looks kind of hard, some of the bits in here. So I don't know how we're going to get on tonight. I don't know how many people have got box 12. I only got it a couple of days ago. And we're putting some more of the frame on. Let me just show you, actually. Stand by. We're going to be, if I just flick through, we're going to be doing a pipe, putting some of the frame on. That bit's easy. And putting these suspensions in, which came in the last pack. That's easy. Then we're going to be putting some more pipes together. So they look like that. That's easy. This one looks to be a living nightmare. We're actually assembling some frame. And then we're kind of, I don't know, putting it on the car by the look of it. It's a little bit crazy. I don't know. That just went to try and go and focus then. 1 second. I'm just going to solve that little issue. Stop it going into focus. There we go. Wow, that's bright. Hang on. Stand by. I think that'll do. I'll check that afterwards. I think that'll do. Yep, that looks cool. Go back there. Right, okay. So we're filling this frame on, but I can't really make out the pictures. And I think that's where the problem is going to be. The last stage, there's hardly anything to do at all. So as you can see, it's just that. But yeah, I think that third one is what's going to keep us awake at night. Hello, Ian. How's it going? Ian, I've just been showing people, I don't know if you caught it, the lovely Terminator. And I've got the, let me put this over here, because I'll knock it off. And I've got the Stormtroopers here as well. Shh, be quiet. So what's been going on? I've been actually doing something that I don't normally do. I've been doing a lot of Arduino programming. A lot of Arduino programming. So much that it's been keeping me up. And today, I don't know if you've ever been coding or programming. You have problems where your code's just not working. It's just not working and you're racking your brains. Well, today, it succeeded. So I'm having a little celebration that what I've been ploughing on for the last 2 days has now gone really good. Did you get the pipe on that you had problems with last time? I did. The pipe, it wasn't the pipe. It was part of the, it was a bit of metal from the frame. Let me just show you that, actually. Let's bring it over. I had problems getting this part on last time. There. And as you can see, they're both on. But we're going to be working on this side of the vehicle. So it's probably best that I bring that up here, actually. So all good. I'm going to turn the aircon on. Because I don't know what it's been like everywhere else in the UK today. But we've had absolute hell with rain, sleet, snow, hail. It's been terrible weather, but unfortunately it's getting hot now, and because it's getting hot, it's raising the humidity levels up, so it's just baking in here at the moment. So it's all good. You're just getting pack one of this. Well, I've had a delivery, so I've been told I'm now allowed to do the Leopard Tank pack 8. So I'm going to be doing the Leopard Tank pack 8. Then next week, you ready for this, I've got to somehow fit in 7 Jaguar 7, Route Master 7, and the Lamborghini Miura, which we're hoping to get out on Thursday. So, I know the Stormtroopers are wicked, Ian. I absolutely love them. So it is the Miura. It's the Miura, Pete. And it looks fantastic, I tell you. It looks absolutely fantastic. So I can't wait to get that. But that's what's going to be going on next week. This week, it's been beautiful sunshine, Chris. Oh, it's been terrible here, I tell you. So tomorrow, on tomorrow's live stream, can't wait for this. Tomorrow, my buddy that hasn't, I don't even think he's visited this new house that I'm in. Because I saw him last year, but I don't think he's been up here for about almost 10 years. But he's coming to visit me for a couple of days. So he's going to be joining on the live stream. His name's Russell. And if you want to know where I get my humour from, it's pretty much him. So I don't know what to expect to tomorrow. But if we've had a beer in us, I just apologise now. But he is like my brother. I called him my brother because we're so alike, as in not looking, just the way we act. So you'll see that. Oh, Esther's on. Hello, Mrs. Welderwayne. How's it going? Mrs. Welderwayne's happy because... hello. Stand by. There you go. You know she's been doing the Cute Bee Dolls House. Well, funny enough, Cute Bee actually saw her videos and want to offer to do her to do another one. So they're doing a collaboration. So she's going to be having a book nook. Is that what it's called? A book nook coming. So she's going to be doing a book nook on the channel. So... Fire Truck 5 on the way. I'm trying to think what I got today. Because I got Jaguar 7. I got the Rootmaster 7. I can't remember what else I got. I got one other thing. I can't remember what it was. It will come to me. You got an email that the Bullet Mustang has been delayed till June. The you know what, Howard? I was going to mention that tonight because I saw... Was it... Steve Forbes, was it, put up about the Bullet Mustang and the, what was the other one, the Batmobile. Now, as far as I'm aware, they're all delayed. They're still all delayed. Now, I've actually got a call with Eagle Moss on Friday, so I'll try and iron that out. But from what I understand, they're still delayed with no release date. But hopefully I'm wrong, and they'll get back to me. Yeah, but Friday morning, I'll be able to let you know about that one, so... It might not be your thing, Jason, but Mrs. Welder Wayne, I'm telling you, she's interesting. Yeah, she's been discovered. Oh, wow, look at this. Chris has been buying Doll's House as well. One of the companies, the Robo Time Company, they wanted me to build, or I thought they wanted me to build one of the like Cute Bee Doll's Houses as well. Instead, they're going to send me a one of these wooden puzzle things. I think I asked for a clock, but I don't know what they're sending me, but I want to have a go to that. You got the fire truck today. It might have been the New York fire truck then, Pete. I'll be honest with you. I had about five things and I just put them to one side because I'm trying to make space in here. And I've taken, Ian, I've taken your poacher and your Ducati and the Volvo out of here because I need space. Because normally now I turn the camera around, but I can't do that because there's something over here which you're not allowed to see yet. So what I can show you though is this is going live on the channel tomorrow. Check that out, Ian. Look at that. So that video has already been done today, but yeah, it's coming along, isn't it? So we've the next thing we're doing the forks. We're getting the handlebars in there. So that is really good. And I'll tell you what, not that you can hear me when I'm turning around like that. It's really heavy as well. So I think you'll be really happy with that. She needs a Mrs. Neon World Wayne sign. Yeah, I suppose she does. Is it right that Super Chat take 40% off any Super Chat money? Yes, Ian, I could probably believe that is right. They do take a great big wad. What I tend to do is that there's a on Twitch, there's a link. And that's the better way to tip the channel. But yeah, it's, they do. But I don't have a say in it, to be honest with you. So... I never focus that much on that, to be honest with you. Now, at the end of May, we're going to be finishing the plaques off. Now, I've done two new ones today, which was Dave Howe and another one. Can't remember what the other one is. That came through part work upgrades. But that means I've got 12 left to do. At the end of the May, that's it. I am running out of space, but they are looking really good up there. So once they're all finished... I'm going to try and get a video where you can actually, like a high resolution, so you can actually see where you are on the wall. So that's going to be good. Hello, Jim. How's it going? You just had the last pack that Welder Wayne built with the fire truck this week, so about a month behind. Oh, my God. Jim, look. Do you like this? Now, I had some PO box mail come through, and one of them was actually sent to me at the beginning of March. It actually arrived at the end of March, but the post office decided not to tell me about it. So I picked it up from the post office. Super Bowl champions. Now, this is from Will and Victoria Dickey from Utah. They actually came to visit me last week because they're in this country. But yeah, it's absolutely brilliant. So I appreciate that. Now, I've had someone called David, which I'm going to show tomorrow, has sent Jack a trading card. Wow, look at that. It wobbles. A silver trading card. And I had another letter, believe it or not, from someone who lives about, 400 yards from the house. So I don't think he realizes that he lives so close to me, which is quite fun. So Orca survived Titanic week. Yeah, it's back. But what I didn't notice was that the fishing rods here, one of them had fallen off and the knife had fallen off as well, where I had the accident where it fell off. So I've got them now. The Orca is now complete again. But I think when I do the Titanic, it's definitely going to be staying up there. But I'm glad you got your little booty bundle, Robert. And I also think that Anthony Oates, you should have received yours today as well. Chris Morris, you will be getting yours. It's been posted out, but you live in America. So it's going by snail mail. So I don't know how long that's going to be. Where did your four hammer go? Right here. So you never know when you need that. It's protection now. So that's just behind me. So at least you knew what was missing. So that was good. Waymint. So instead of sending it through YouTube, why don't we arrange a backdoor system, PayPal or something? Troy, there is already a backdoor system. Stand by. I'll tell you what it is. I'll probably have to put it advertise it on the channel or something. It's I haven't looked at this for ages, to be honest with you. Stand by. It is. I'm just trying to get a link. So if I go to about there. Okay. So it's through Stream Elements. That's the link there. I think that might come up on the Stream Elements bot. I don't know. I only use Stream Elements for this lovely overlay that you can see there. So it's all cool. Yeah, the Spitfire was a crying shame, literally. The thing is, Jason, that as you saw, it was working. Everything was working fine. I hadn't touched it until that lifter was sort of like a cascade of problems. Whatever happened to that lifter and the board, and just so you know, I hadn't used any power mods or anything because I hadn't got around to installing that yet. This was just on the batteries. Whatever happened on the board had a chain reaction effect to the plane. And the propeller stopped working. And then when I tried to fix the propeller and take the plug out, I stripped the JST connector off the wires. So I was like, oh, this is just getting worse and worse. And then I got to the point where I thought, if I don't stop, I'm going to throw it out the window. And I wanted my dad to have something. But even when I did put it together, it still wasn't fitting right. Where the engine cowl is, I had to bend that metal round to shape the Spitfire. Because otherwise, it would have been sitting out right. It was a terrible fit. So, It's crazy. Crazy, crazy. Yeah, it's a scam. Everything's a scam. But there you go. But there is, I'm always, I miss the positive I am. I always look on the bright side. The Zero Fighter is going perfectly at the moment. And the good thing about the Zero Fighter, unlike the Spitfire, is that we tested it as we went along. We tested every single component to make sure it worked. So we haven't had a chance to do that with the Spitfire, unfortunately. But that build's done and dusted. We're not going to worry about that now. As I said, we've got the Lamborghini Miura starting next week. We're in America in, God, how many days now? 18, 17. In 17 days, just over 2 weeks, I'm going to be in America. And when we're in America, hopefully, I'll be announcing a new build for you. And if you've been watching my social media, there has been some hints. And no one's got it yet, but a lot of people, because I disabled comments, because some people are getting very close. And I didn't want everyone to know, so I was like, oh my God. Wow. Yeah, that did work, as you just saw there, Ian. It popped up on the screen. Holy crap. Oh my God. Thank you. Thank you for that. It doesn't come up in my chat here, because the chat's only on YouTube. But it does come up on the board there, and that's where I saw it. Wow. Ian, thank you so much. you've thrown me now, so I've got to build this and not know what to say. Enterprise D is a car crash. Yeah, the Enterprise D, I'm deliberately delaying it until I can figure out how this saucer section fits to the bridge section. And the reason I need to know that is because if I'm going to have to stick a metal rod for it, I'm going to have to reinforce those panels inside. And I don't want to put panels on top of that metal structure until I've realized that. But you know what? This week, I've been fabricating absolutely loads. Absolutely loads. I've been using a 3D printer with a Titanic today. That scroll saw and the drill press there has been worked out. But again, I can't test that. You were testing it. You had to test it, didn't you? I guess it worked. I don't know. I'll soon tell you. Oh, it's all fun. It's all fun. I'm on Stream Elements now, so yeah, it worked. It worked. Oh my god. That's just crazy. You know, that's probably the first time we've done that, Ian. And you know that, you know this thing on top here? Well, I can get it to say that as well when people donate to that, but I need to activate the Twitch version of that. So what I might do is have the same thing that I've got over the top down the bottom, and then rather than World of Wayne, I'll have World of Wayne with the YouTube logo there, and then down the bottom I'll have World of Wayne with a Twitch logo. Lots of changes, as you saw, with the countdown timer at the moment. But I am doing the resin windows in the neck as well. Jimmy, I'm doing resin windows everywhere. So. What was that? You're in Germany tomorrow. Ah. Oh, probably won't be able to watch the live stream. Ah. Well, I mean, I think the weather's going to be really nice tomorrow over here. So hopefully in Germany, it's really good over there. That scroll saw is noisy as heck. Yeah, it is. Not as noisy as the Ecto-1 lights. Yeah, I don't think anyone has got stock of issue 21 yet. So I don't know what's going on. But once again, I have got a call with Eagle Moss on Friday. So I'll be able to find out what's going on there. Which is all cool. Something's just set off the motion sensor. Anyway, look, we're going to get on with it because I don't know if we're going to be able to manage this tonight. It's one of these car crash. We didn't do a stream last night, so I think Car Crash Tuesday is going to hit tonight. So once again, if I don't see your comment, I apologize for that. It's because I'm really focusing on this. The Enterprise D will have a strong connection between Saucer and Battlebridge due to the structure they've already given us. I hope so, Chris. I hope so. We'll see. Okay, let's do this. Okay, so that's far too washed out. Let me just muck around with the cameras. It's because I've done an update on this computer, you see, and when you do an update, it resets all my cameras back. So I'm gonna turn that down again. Whoops, down one more. There you go. Oh, no, turn the gain down. That's not too bad. Turn the white balance down. I think we can go with that. Right, okay. Cool. Excellent. Okay. So I showed you what we're doing. Let's get the pack out and get this started. Now, obviously, all these instructions are in French. So I'm guessing with a lot of it. So I'm just going to put this here. Grab the first pack. And this is pack 45 that we're working on. Now, with Agora Models, pack 1 just went up to stage 5, I think. So we're obviously now 40 stages ahead of where Agora Models is. And just like the Peugeot, you're absolutely right, Dennis. The quality of this build is amazing. I love this one. But the first thing I need are these pipes. And we've got a little tiny section somewhere which I'm looking for. There it is. I need that. You know what, let's just get everything out. I'll leave these bits for a minute because I'm going to need them afterwards. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to be putting this little bit here, and it says L. It's got a little L on it, so we know where it's going. It's just going to go in here like that, held in with an AP screw. So that starts easier. Okay. I say that, but the Ducati was a fun build today, Ian, I have to say. But as you see, it's looking amazing.
The grey cutting mat. Yeah, it might be. It might be. But I prefer the lighter colours than the darker colours. So once we've done that, we're going to piece this one together. So we've got a full pipe like that. And again, we're looking at the AP screws just to put these together. I did have a white cutting mat before. As a matter of fact, I'm probably going to need to get another cutting mat, because if you've noticed, Mrs. Welder Wayne has been doing her gluing on this, and it's already got marks on it. Now, I'm aware that the other side of this is going to be perfectly clear, but you know, you tell your wife to look after things, and she doesn't. Okay, so that's the pipe done. Now, we've got an end to put in the pipe. So the end that's got this connection on here has now got this, which looks like an end of a trumpet. And that just pushes on. Just checking that. Don't know. I'm going to leave it on, but you probably might want to glue that into place. We'll see. Okay. Now, this is where things are going to get a bit tricky. Okay. I don't want to do this. So we've got this cage that we've now got to put onto this section here. Now, it's going to go kind of, I'm guessing, I don't know which way round it goes. Does it go this way? Stand by. Just looking at where they want me to screw this in. No, it goes with these pins facing down. So one in, oh God. There we go. Right, so we've got, just trying to figure out where they actually lock in. The pictures aren't very clear at all. It looks like they go into these holes just here. So we've got one in here and one in there. There you go. Now the other side of this, trying to figure out how the hell we're going to get in there. Sorry, I just swore again. Stand by. I'm looking. The other end of this is going to go into a hole that I've got here. Aha, there we go. Pretty impossible to show you, but behind the shock here, I've got a screw hole that I need to put this in. Now that's going to be held in with an IM screw, so it might be best if I get one in first and then figure out the placement down the bottom here. But this is going to be tricky, and I'm very much aware you can't see anything, but at the moment it is what it is. Unfortunately, we've got a, oh God, we've got the suspension in the way, so it is going to stop it a little bit. Well, I put one in really loose. Let's get this back in there. Cool. No. Oh yeah, no, it hasn't come out. Cool. Turn it around. Again, I know you can't see this, but you can watch my pain. That's gone a bit dark, hasn't it? Let me brighten that up a little bit. I'm getting fussy for the. There you go. Get this other one in. See, I can see the hole, but whether it can go in there or not's another thing. I knew this was going to be a problem. Just knew it. I'm more interested in getting this screw in than worrying about where it is at the front at the moment. Car crash Tuesday. Right, I'm standing up and being quiet while I figure this out. Just seeing where the hole is. Always helps to know where the hole is. Okay. So, got it in the hole. But it doesn't want to screw in at the moment. And I don't know why. We got it. Right, line up the bottom. It's still not helping me about what hole it goes in. I think it might go in the back ones, actually. Stand by. Has anyone actually done this stage? I'm having trouble. Just having a look. This picture. It looks like it does go into this back hole here. So, we'll try and get it in. There you go. That's in. Right. Everyone's happy. Let's tighten this up. That's one side done. That was what I thought was going to be the hardest part of this whole build. So, can you see down the bottom where I've got this? So you got, you should be able to see two holes here, but I've put it in that hole just there. So, you can't really hear the aircon. Believe me, the aircon's really loud, but I have got a little bit of noise filtering on here, so... But I would be cooking if I'm not wearing it. All right, okay, that's cool. Okay, so that's in. We've got that cage in place. I'm so happy we managed to do that. That was a bit of a mare, that one. So now we've done that, all we're going to do now is we're going to take these shocks from the last pack, and these are going to go over the top of these sections here, but we need to put them over the top this side of the bar. So they're going to go in kind of like this, and it's probably going to take some wiggling to get this all the way down. Let me use my screwdriver just to angle that better. Get in there. There we go. And then the other side of this is just going to go onto that ledge just there. And that's going to be held in with one of the flanged KM screws. See? That wasn't too bad at all. He says... Okay, I'm just going to move that there, just while I get this one in. What side? It goes in this side. I can't... there you go. Put this all the way in. And that's one side done. And then it's just a case of rinse and repeat. So once again... I wonder if it's better just to put the spring in first. Let's see if that helps. I doubt it, but who knows. It is a little bit fiddly to getting all this lined up. There we go. So the spring's in. Again, put the other side of the shock in and just put it over that little lip there. Get myself a flange screw. And once again, put this in. You're going to have radiant heating in my toy barn. That'll be cool. I got a chili Aster thing from JML Direct last year. Good as the air conditioner. I need the air conditioner in the summer. It can get hot in here. Ian knows that. There you go. So that's all there is to do in that stage. So I'm going to just put this to one side. We do. Oh, crap. One second. That's not good. We do have those parts there which just catapulted themselves across the workshop, but I managed to get them. You know what? This is one of those streams where if it's going to go wrong, it's going to go wrong. And remember, we've got this as well. Okay. So next pack is pack 46. And again, we've just got some small details to put in here. So, I don't actually think these go in the car. I think we just got to save them for the next stage, which is the stage that I've been worried about, to be honest with you. So, there we go. These, Ian, have been the bane of my life today, trying to figure out where pipes go on that bike. But, you certainly gave me a challenge, that's for sure. Okay, so, first thing we're going to do, we've got this box here. I'd like to tell you what it's called, but it's in French. I haven't got a clue. So making sure we put it around the right way, which is not that way. It's this way here. so obviously the colors match all the way around. That's going to be held in with AP screws. The screw of choice on this build. Excellent. And put two of these in. You've got cheap geothermal energy in my radiators. We don't really have the heating on in the house here. We've got some sort of beanbag pellets in the walls. But there you go. That's that done. We're going to add something to this side on the back, which looks like this. Again, I'm not sure what this is, but this is slightly off-center here. If you can see that, slightly off-center. We need to make sure the off-center part is the one that's facing down. So it's going to go on that way, like that. Once again, held in with AP screws. I've got absolutely no idea what this is. Does anyone want to hazard a guess what this is? I wish I knew. It's position à la jambe de force. Jambe de force? Oh, do we... I can't even read French, let alone speak it. We never studied French in my school. It was all German in our school. There we go. So that's in like that. Now we have got a nipple. This wouldn't be a Wayne World of Wayne stream if we didn't say the word nipple at least once, which we've got to put this pipe on. Just checking the fit, and it fits really tight. If it didn't fit tight, then I'd obviously glue that. But that's done there. And then once again, we've got a pipe to sort out, exactly like we did last time. Just checking all the pieces we got here. That's what I was looking for. And this is the one mirroring like we've done last time, but this time it says R for right on it, which is there. So just got to make sure I put this in the right way. It goes in this way with the R facing upwards to us. And that's held in once again with an AP screw. It's all Greek to you. Oh, bless. I knew enough German when I was in Germany to order myself some food. But the first day I was so scared to speak German. I've probably told you this story before that I think I ended up ordering a banana covered in chocolate. And that's what I had to eat for the whole day. But I found myself an O'Neill's Irish bar while I was out there. I've got a funny feeling I'm putting this in the wrong way. Stand by. So when I found that Irish bar, I was happy then. I was getting fed. I knew I wasn't going to die. Okay, that's good. Really hard to cool our house down. Mrs. Parkwork keeps the house toasty to the extreme and then still complains of being cold. Yeah, I know someone like that. Someone who can't regulate their body temperature. Okay, so we're going to put these two pieces together, just like last time. And once again, held in with the AP screws. This is all the fiddly details before we start working on the frame. Now, I don't know how many packs this is. It's going to be the same as the Peugeot. Now, didn't the Peugeot go up to stage 30? I can't remember. Pack 30? I can't remember. There we go. That's that. And then obviously in this end here, once again, we've got the sort of trumpet section. So now we've got two of these looking like that. We don't actually do anything with these, though. Put them to one side. We're going to be building something else now, which is with this part here. These are all metal, by the way. We're not mucking around with plastic here. We're going to be putting this shaft in this way, making sure that this here, the end there, let me just show you that, is facing in the same direction that these are facing. So it's going to go on like this when I can get it in. Oh, just put it in wrong. There you go. So it's facing that way like that. Okay, we need to hold this in. So once again, KM screw. That's the flange screw from last time. I'm not going to open another pack up. Put that in a little bit of oil. And we'll get that screwed in. Again, these sort of screws are the ones that I normally have accidents with. But I've been really good lately. So that's in. Then on the other end of that, we've got this little tab here, which is going to go this way round, over the top. Sort of going to hold everything together there. And that's going to be held in, once again, with a KM screw again. This looks like a bonnet lever, you know, that you hoist the bonnet up with. It's probably not, but that's what it looks like. So I'll get this one in. Perfect. So there we go. We've got this detail here, which is complete. This from the last pack. These two things. And this. And that is all there is to do in that stage. Now it's time to get messy. Not looking forward to this at all. Okay, so we're doing stage... Wow, this is big. 47, is that right? Let me just look. Yep, stage 47. Quite a big pack, because obviously the frame here is absolutely ginormous. So, get this all out. Make sure there's nothing in there. Look at the size of that. Okay. Right, we're good. No idea how they want me to start tackling this, so I think the first thing to do is probably take everything out and kind of put it neatly in some sort of pile. So we've got two of these sections here which look exactly the same. They're the same size and everything. We've got screws, which I'll keep over that side. We've got what looks to be brackets here and tiny metal. These are all metal, tiny metal brackets. And then some more screws over here. That's it. Right. So, first thing he wants me to do, just trying to figure this out now, is what way round have they got this? They've got this way round. And on the arms that are coming out the... Oh, God. This doesn't make sense. these arms here... are going to be coming off these square things here. Now they come off the back sections, and I'm guessing that they might be labeled L and R. They are L and R. So who knows what left and right is in French. I'm guessing that this is going on the back of the car, is it? So if it is, that would be the left side. So I'm guessing that's going to go in there like that. 45B, let me just check. 45B, I don't know what. I don't know if that's left or right. But anyway, look, it's going to go in here, and it's held in with an AM screw. I'll look at chat in a second, hang on. Because I'm sure someone's telling me what left and right is. I don't know. If I put this the wrong way around, we might end up having to change this around again. But, I'm guessing this is... Let me just see how this goes on the car. Hang on a second. That don't help. Well, we don't actually put this on the car. But I am right. This is going on the back section of the car. So this definitely has to go. I've got a funny feeling I've got this upside down as well. I think it goes on that way. Like that, with this going down. Again, the pictures aren't really clear at all. Stand by, I'm just looking again. Links is left, that's German. Okay, look, the pictures don't make any sense to me at all, because is there any details on here? Right. You see this, look, we haven't got one of these on this side. Look, we've got one here, we haven't got one here. So we need to make sure when we do this, that this is on the left side, so I have got it the right way around. The last thing I want to do is screw all of these in and realise that they're not meant to go here. So that's the first one in. I don't think I'm going to make that too tight at the moment, because I've got to put the other one in, which goes in the other side here. Just like that, once again, held in with an AM screw. D and G, thank you. That tab is what you need to focus on. That way you know what way round you're meant to have it. Okay, here's the second one. Putting the screw in is actually putting the sort of direction this needs to go. Just having a look at that. There you go. So they look like that there. Okay, that's the first thing. This is why I got worried about this stage of the build, because it's hard to see what's going on. So, 46K, what's that? Ah, so this section that we made last time, which they're now calling 46K, with this end on here, is going to go somewhere. Okay, so this is going like that. Then this is going, wow, standby. This doesn't make sense. Hang on, I'm just looking at my picture again. So if this is facing down, then on this cross beam here, we've got this going on top of that section. So that's going on here like this. That's what they're saying. But what way round would it go? It goes through this square, so it's going to be that way round, like that. Well, I'm going to take their word for it. It's a KM screw. The instructions aren't very clear here. This is why I knew this was going to be a problem, this one. Okay, so if this is in right, this is going on this way. Held in with a KM screw. There you go. And we can screw that in. Now I'm just going to tighten up this screw in here now. Just like that. And then I'm going to see if that's working. So we've got that here. And it should be... That's in the right place, but this bit here at the top, I'm just going to take it out, needs to be the other side of this pipe here. So I'm just going to take that out and put it in that way, like that. There you go. Okay, the good news is it matches the picture now, I think. I'm just looking. It definitely matches the picture. I want to tighten this up a little bit more. Not very tight, I have to say. I don't think I can get this any tighter. Let me try this screwdriver. There you go. Because I want it to be able to hold its own weight. Still can go tighter. There you go. All good. So that's on like that. I hope so. I don't know. So they gave us a picture of what it should look like, and it does look like that. But now they want us to fold it down. So that's going to be folded down just like that for now. Okay, we can put that to one side because we've got these two bits here, which are going to go into the metal bits that we've got here. And quite simply, these are... Just looking, they're exactly the same at either end, so it doesn't matter what end we use. But they're going to be sitting on top like that. Can you see that? Like that. So they're sort of like a gap. I'd expect them to sit that way, but no, they want them on this way. Yep, so we need an AM screw again, which I've got here. Again, absolutely no idea where these go. And we'll put this in. These wearer screwdrivers, I'm telling you, when it comes to metal, they're wimps. You need something really chunky like this. As you can see, look how much more oomph I can get on that. There you go. So, again, I'm going to show you a close-up what that looks like. So it's on like that there. Do the same on the other side. The AM screw ready. And again... We want that to be sitting. Hello, this is slightly different. Let me have a look at that. This one's already been bent. I don't think it's... They're both meant to be bent down. This one seems to be straight, but it's meant to be bent. So I'm going to get my duckbill pliers and bend it back to where it's supposed to be. and hopefully it will there you go. That's how it's meant to be. Just turn the bottom up as well. Oops, I'm about to cut it then with pliers. See, it's not all singing and dancing when we get this. There we go. So, similar way, put this on here, held in with an AM screw. They, I mean, the online's in English, and obviously when Agora Models get it, it's going to be in English. I don't know who's translating it, though. Okay. So that's that one in as well. So we've got two that now mirror. Where do these go? Okay, so we've got to bring the vehicle back over. We're working on the front now, according to this. Now, I've got all of these wires here, but they want me to put one end. This doesn't make sense. Stand by. Is that upside down? This is upside down, so I need to turn it upside down. There you go. Okay, I'm looking closely. Right. Stand by. All right, I think, right, okay, I'm trying to figure this out. One end's gonna go here. I'm trying to figure out where the other end goes. I think it goes behind. Stand by. It goes through. This isn't making any sense to me at all. This might be where I've got my problem, because I put my things in the wrong way round. Just having a look there. They don't go where they said they should go. Hmm. Okay, so they definitely go onto this bit here. I can confirm that bit. But then the other end apparently is going into this wheel. Kind of like that. But, no, wrong one. Look at me, I'm doing the wrong one. It's over on this end here, that's better. And then the other end goes into the wheel here. Right, okay, I've got it now. Okay, so, KM screw. No, CM screw. And we'll put this bit in here. Now, I'm not going to be able to complete this fully on my one, because I do have to turn those things around that I put in the wrong way. The little caliper at the front, because these are going to mount to it. But if I get this side in, then I will take the wheels off and do that in a second. Because this is meant to fit. Just having a look. Oh, I don't know, actually. Let me get my torch out. Oh, no, it doesn't go in there. Thought it did. I'll figure out where the other side goes. We've got to put a right, stand by, figuring this out. We've got to put a little bracket on this. So, wow, okay. So what they want us to do, God, you're not going to like this. I'm looking at it. They want us to put one of these brackets on here. Okay, but to get this in, we need to take this screw out. They want us to take this DM screw out. Oh dear. So I will take this DM screw out, like they're telling me to do. Stand by. I don't know where that cable's supposed to go. Let me just hide that down there. Right, that's the DM screw out. And then they want me to replace it with an EM screw through the other side, but with one of these brackets on. Now, the problem I can see here, which doesn't make any sense to me at all, is that the EM screw, I think, is going to be too big to go into this hole. So I'm going to do a dry fit first before I put the bracket on. That doesn't make sense. Just looking at that. It has to go through this way because it's holding a bracket on. I can see this being something that they've cocked up, because I'm going to be able to get it in there. But why didn't we do this at the time? It doesn't make sense. So I'll put the bracket on. Just like this. Get it in the hole. Which I really want to just start it. Ah, crap. Just dropped it. Hang on. Oh, I hate it when we're having to do corrections like this. I'm going to turn this around because I'm not left-handed. Because then I've got to sort of like put the whole car back together again, or that whole tire back together. This isn't happening. Okay, if I can start this up. Okay, we've started it. Put the tire back in. And then tighten that up completely. There you go. So it can be done, it's just a pain in the neck. Right, I'm just going to hold this piece up while I tighten it up. Where's my big screwdriver? Sorry you can't see this. But short of me getting really annoyed with this now. Can't believe we're rectifying something. Okay, almost there. There you go. Right. Trouble is, we need this to be facing upwards, so I can't do it too tight until I get the, there you go, in there. Right, so I'm going to turn this back and show you what I mean now. We've got to do this on both sides. So I've put this little hinge, a little bracket in the top here, and this is going to go underneath like that, and it's held in with an AM screw. That was pretty crazy, wasn't it? Just like this. Why did we have to do that now? There we go, that's in, and guess what? We've got to do exactly the same on the other side. Crazy. Okay, so once again, this will be going on here. KM screw. Hang in there, Wayne. Crack it on standby. Yeah, I'm going to need it later. I told you this stage was going to be a pain, didn't I? Okay, so that goes over the top. We might be able to do this one quicker. Oops, I've got this. That's not the right screw. I want a CM, not a KM screw. Stupid me. Okay, so CM screw in here. That's better. Just like that. Turn my torch off. We don't need that for the minute. Get that quite tight, but enough so I can still move it around. And then once again, I've got to take the screw out of here, which isn't easy, I tell you that now, because obviously you've got the fuel system in the way. Why didn't we do this at the time? Okay, that's almost out. I think I can just pull that out now. No. Oh, come on. It's definitely out. Let's get me tweezers on and see if I can pull this out. You have one of those screws that just don't want to come out. Come on. I can't even turn it. That's the problem. Let's try this one. There you go. It's like doing a tooth extraction, Chris. We're out. As you can see, the wheel's hanging off. Now I need pliers. That'll do it. It just doesn't want to come out. It's being stubborn. Right, let's try again. I'm trying to pull it while I'm turning. There we go. We got the extraction was successful. And we're replacing that with an E screw. EM screw, I think that's what it was. Can't remember the title of it. Which was this one. Which means I need another bracket, which I'm looking for. There it is. And once again, get this into place. I think we're not going to be able to get to the last stage of this because there's still crap loads to do on this. But if I have problems, then as you know, chances are other people are having the same problem. Sorry, I'm going to have to turn this around so I can actually see this again. These sort of things is where I get frustrated because we shouldn't be doing this. And because obviously this is all blacks, I can't, there you go, I can't really see the hole very well. But I've got that lined up, get that screwed in. Whoops, it's not in where it needs to be. There you go, it is now. I'm gonna change my screwdriver here. You can't see nothing. There you go. You can watch me screwing in. You need extra time. Yeah, I think I will. I just want to get this bit in because I think this stage is going to be the fiddliest. See, so that's in now. Perfect. Get me AM screw loaded up because I've just got to put this section here just through the bottom there. And attach it and then just tighten everything up. So, whoops, just like we did on the last side. I wonder how many people are going to comment about this one when it goes up. I mean, this won't be going up on the channel, just so you know, because on the main channel I'm only putting the live streams up for this one. And this is a Patreon stream. Oh god, this isn't happening. Come on, let me tighten this up a little bit. One second. It keeps moving, you see, so I'm trying to get it tight. So I wouldn't mind, but it's a fiddly part of the build, and we've already started working on the back. I think we go back to working on the back in a second. There you go, that one's in. Finally, right, tighten this up. And then we can never talk about this again. So that's that one in. And just this one here. Perfect. So, if I turn this around, that's those two parts here in place. Everybody's happy. Right. Just going to see what else we need to do. I've done that. That's how it should look. All right, so the other two bits they want me to do is just making me look at it and saying how nice it looks. And you're right, it does. It looks nice. And that's it. Wow, we've done that stage. That was all there is to do in that stage. You know what? We've got 3 minutes. Let me just see what we've got left to do, because the last stage is dead quick. Let's go and do the last stage. If you don't mind holding on for another 5 minutes. All we've got to do... Wow. Can't believe that. Is we've just got these parts here. And quite simply, all we're doing is having this this way round. Let me just get the right way. This way round. This is going to be going on the bottom into. Ah, right. Okay. So just picking which frame it is. It's this frame here with these facing upwards. And this is facing the same way. So we're going to have these two sections here going onto that section there, I'm guessing. Nope, Hang on, I'm trying to get it around the way they've got it. No, it's this one here. Right. They're going to be going on 1, 2, 3 onto those points there. And this is going to lock in at the top into the little spindle there. There we go. Look, we got it. Right. So, that doesn't make sense. Because, have I put this round the wrong way? No, it doesn't. It does. It definitely goes into these bits here. They're saying it doesn't lock in. Oh dear. Okay, so that's going in like that. That's definitely what they've got in the picture, isn't it? It is. So we're going to put them in with AM screws. Let's do that quickly. That was crazy. I'll look up in a minute and realize everyone's gone to bed. It just seems weird. It seems like it would be more comfortable going in the other way, but this is the way that they're telling me to put it in, so I will put it in the way they tell me. Let's get that through there first. I can line one of them up. Excellent. Get another screw. And line this one up. The only other bit I've got left to do after this is about 5 seconds, so. And another screw. Just to line the front one up here. Which goes into that hole just there. They are all AM screws, aren't they? 1, 2. I think so, yeah. Yep, they are. Tighten them up. With me big whacker. And there we go. You get the idea. I really thought that this goes into here. But it doesn't. They haven't got that in there on the picture. So I guess it doesn't. So that's cool. So I can put that to one side. And all that's left to do is just to put the lenses into this section here. So we've got one of the indicators, I guess this is. That goes in like that. We've got the reflector to put in. Which is going to go in this way. Over the top. And that's held in just with an AP screw. Which I've got here. Wow, how late are we? We're about 3 minutes late. That ain't too bad. And this is just going to go into this point here to hold everything together. Yay! And then all we got to do is put this into something. The front here. It's going to go on the front. Just looking at the picture. That way round. And it's going to go on to these two little holes here. So it's going to go on like that. That way round. And I'm securing that in with AM screws. Which I've got here. Where's my little screwdriver? Because this won't take long at all. Saying that, we are going into metal. This is, let this be a lesson that I chat too long. I'll read your above comments once I've finished this bit. But there you go. We're done. That's all there is to do in that stage. Let me go back to the camera. I need a rum now. Oh my god. Putting orange tubes into the engine was pretty scary. Be sure to read my above comments. Let's have a look. Bergdis, the 9 months in their tow lights, a custom BF Goodrich Space Saver spare tire and 2 storage areas, so it could be classified as a sports car, not a prototype. That's interesting. But we did get there in the end. We managed to get it working. Enjoy yourself in Germany tomorrow. I don't know if you're still watching, Robert, and I'm glad we managed to get this stage done. I wasn't intending on actually having to take bits out, but obviously it is what it is. We've seen that before with a Spitfire, so I'm not too impressed that we're doing that with a Porsche. Chances are, when the Agora Models one comes out, we're going to be doing the same thing. But there you go. Take care, everyone. Have a nice sleep. And I will catch you tomorrow, which we've got the Ducati released, and we're doing the live stream with my friend tomorrow evening. So take care.